How old do you think you are? Think. Thinking. Do you know? Do you still think about the fact that you probably have the best looking legs of all the men in New York City? Do you think about that? How much do you think about how hard your feet hit the ground in the morning when the smell of pancakes, butter, and syrup surface your palate? Think. Think? Do you think? Well, I have a poem for you, young man. You've probably heard it many times. It's by Archibald MacLeish. From about 300 million years ago. It's called 11. And summer mornings, the mute child, stupid, rebellious, hating the words, hating the meanings, hating the think now, and the think, and the oh, but think. Would leave on tiptoe the three chairs on the veranda, crossing tree by tree the empty lawn, push back the shed door, and upon the sill stand pressing out the sunlight from his eyes, and enter, and with outstretched fingers feel the grindstone, and behind it the bare wall, and turn, and on the cool hard earth sit listening. And one by one, out of the dazzled shadow in the room, the shapes would gather. The brown plowshare, the spades, the mattocks, polished helves of picks, shovels, slender tines are glinting across the curve of sickles. Shapes older than men were, the wise tools, the iron friendly with earth, and sit there breathing the harsh, dry smell of the withered bulbs, the faint odor of dung, the silence. And outside, beyond the half-shut door, the blind leaves and the corn moving. And at noon, would come up from the garden, his hard, crooked hands gentle with earth, his knees still earth stained, smelling of sun, of summer, the old gardener. He would bend over his baskets, and they would not speak. No, they would say nothing. And the child would sit there happy as though he had no name, as though he had been nobody.